Yeah. It's back. I took a couple days off because you know what happened in Sunday. We have first match against is Blackburn. It's away. I'll wait for you to join. Meanwhile, I'm just gonna go around the save. Yeah, we are sitting second behind West Brom. We are 9 points behind them. But I think it's possible. I think it is extremely difficult, but possible. Yeah. Finances is shit. Here is the youth academy. Now that I promote a couple players. Meanwhile, I'm gonna promote this guy, Stoyan Klaassen. Overall of 53, potential 70 to 94. He seems like the kind of player that needs a Maybomb. Very good physicals, okay technicals. I mean, not okay, just shocking technicals, really. His tackling stats, both slide and stand tackle, are okay, but the rest is just shocking. And for the left back, they need ball control, they need dribbling. You know? At least he's got short passing and heading accuracy, which is nice. But it's still shocking. Mental attributes, only the aggression. The rest just gone down the shitter. Scouts, we've got this guy until May. Yeah. In Belgium. Matt Stucker. Stuckler in Poland and Richard Fry in Mexico. And the reason I'm scouting Mexico is because I had a sick player in my old save at Bristol. He was the best striker I've had in FIFA 16. I mean, taking Mikael Uriga, because that guy was still very good. But I think if I had the time, if I didn't overwritten the save, I think he would have become the best striker ever. Better than Nakimov, better than Piscopo even. Think what you will, but I think that guy had the potential to be the best. About injuries, yeah, we've got pretty unfortunate injury. Alexander Oliver, he's out for five more months. He's already been out for 2 months. Let me just check. Alexander Oliver showing great potential. I still believe in that, even though he's gonna be out for long. Unfortunately, it was the kind of player that I really didn't want this injury. I'd rather get that injury to someone average like Schwolo, etc. But nah. Alexander Oliver is by far the best right back we have. Fortunately, he injured himself just before the transfer window. During the transfer window even, I think. And we bought Eckstein in, which can do the job at right back while he recovers. There you go. High work rates, perfect for a wing back in my opinion. You want them high work rates. Same with Porter, just medium defensive. It's okay. It's okay. Wing backs, I like wing backs overlapping, so there you go. And then the centre backs to stay back. Right, let's get on with the episode. We are going to face former teammate Mesa Cavedo. He has gone there for 1 million 1.6 million pounds. Let's hope we can beat his ass and prove our team is better than theirs. Right, the team is a bit tired, as you can see. I'm gonna put Coquette Russo in, and on the bench I'm gonna put Sissoko because he's fresh. Tembe I'm gonna take off, I'm gonna put on Ameng, and I'm gonna put Schwolo on for Barradas Navais. Because, you know, Barradas Navais is just knackered. Moscato Salve doesn't... don't think he's fit enough to fit to go into the team yet. Maybe I should put Saunders in for then Levy. Nah. Think it's cool. Saunders just for the what you call it, for the cup games. There we go. Think Loopy can start. No. We'll leave him on the bench. I think I'm gonna start this team actually, like it is. Let's go. There we go.
Should have a fine game for you today. Welcome to it. Martin Tyler here, along with Alan Smith. It's Blackburn Rovers today against Carlisle United. Carlisle United, a real spring in their step on the back of that home win in their previous game against Southend.
Yeah, 3-1, and they could have had more. Really good victory, and I think they'll follow it up with another one here.
Yeah, there's the lineups. Sean Winnell is fifth on top players to watch. He's the player to watch for this game, so.
Blackburn Rovers will line up like this. I've been watching them train this week. They've been polishing up the diamond in midfield in a 4-4-2 formation.
Yeah, and the man at the forward point of that diamond, Martin, behind the two strikers, he's important. He can make things happen.
This is the lineup for the away side.
And here is ours. Ericsson, Solero Santos and Karakunaka for Prune, Hamill, Clivey and Charles in the midfield, Porter Anderson, Coquette Russo,
well,
and
a,
Epstein
a
in
the
defence.
Today, haven't we, with the player
and finally,
he's tracking his old teammates.
Yeah, I think
Ross
it's always
Anyan
an emotional
in the
time
net.
When you face your former club, so you just want to concentrate on doing himself justice.
We're ready to watch Carlisle United here, aren't we, Alan Smith?
Well, you have to say, things are looking good for this
there
side
go.
At the moment, in a promotion spot, which we did expect from them. Got plenty of rivals.
Who's
trying to knock them off course, but experience and quality in this squad to go right through to the end.
Evans.
Grimes. The shot's
and
up! And it's just over the bar.
Just over the bar.
Shot's on here. And there's the shot, so oh, it's way, way over the bar.
There you go. No, far. Come on, yes. Well done, Anderson. Well done, Clisby. Over in the side to Porter. Oh my god, get out of the fucking way, man. The shot is on, but fortunately is well wide.
Here's Porter.
There we go. Good through ball. Salero Santos. Trying to twist and turn to do so. Well played by him nonetheless.
Castro.
Yeah. Henley, good 1-2 there. Grimes. Back to Grimes inside. Evans, Mesa Quevedo, look at the threat. Well done by Mesa Quevedo to lay it off.
Keeping us up to date as usual.
Castro now has the ball back to Mesa Quevedo. Watch out, it's Evans. Back to Castro, save it. Well done, Ross. Very well done.
Could be a problem. Got to defend it well.
What a save from Ross Anyan. Good header out. Eriksen. Well done. Skips past his marker but can't get the through ball. Trying to find Salero Santos with the pass. There he is, tackling Tony Spurt.
He's moved in trying to jostle the opponent off his stride.
What the fuck? How's that not a foul? Charles gets it back to... Oh my god! Fuck off, ref! What are you doing? What are you doing, man? Fuck me. Well, hello to whoever joined the stream. Hope you're having a good time. Please enjoy. Please leave a like.
Grimes, able to make
and yeah, nothing's happened in the stream. Just we're in our first match. 20 minutes, boring encounter so far. Very well done by Clisby. Gets inside. Back Hammett. To Hamill. Tries to lay it off, couldn't do so.
Turnover here.
By the way, we are Grimes. Playing against Mesa Quevedo now on Blackburn. He moved after a transfer accepted from us. 1.6 million
Tommy
pounds
Spur.
Was the transfer fee. In January. In the summer.
Well, this is great team
there
work.
He is, losing there, possession. Winnell, back to Mesa Quevedo. He shields off his man,
well,
but can't get
the
shot off.
But he went with the weaker one, and it showed, Alan.
Yeah, a bit of a swinger.
And by the way, please let me know what did you think of the Euro final? Because I did a prediction here. It was going very well. 28 of 8 views. Just checked it before this episode. Two likes. I mean, one of the best bids I've made. Clearly for you guys. And I guess the winner. I guess the winner.
Charles.
Not in FIFA, third. In
nice
real world as well, because in
great
real life as well, because
goalkeeper.
I thought Portugal was
going to
win, but on penalties. Not 1-0. That screamer from Ede, was just great. I've watched all game, like live. Sorry I couldn't get anything going, like reactions of final etc, because I don't have a proper cam to record. I mean, I've got a photo cam, the normal camera,
that
you know,
is a cheap piece
but
of
it's not that great
like
quality
that.
So you know, still I was going mad when Edna just called, because it was fucking great, you know. Every countryman enjoys their team doing well. Every countryman wants his nation to do well in everything. And we've got our first big trophy. Yesterday they've come back. Oh my god. The response. I mean, you should see the streets of Lisbon, where I live. I mean, they didn't pass through my house, but they've checked on the airport, which is nearby, and they've gone throughout the whole city of Lisbon. It was fucking sick. I went to the Liberty Avenue in the downtown Lisbon to check them out. I've seen everyone. It was fucking great, trust me. Ericsson is through, and it's a goal. Nice. Yeah, talking about the national side, here they are doing well as well. I'm winning without properly focusing on the match. Nice. It's always nice to see. Great ball from Salego Santos, picks out the main man, Ericsson himself, and he bangs it in.
Well, let's take another look at the goal.
So, yeah, please let me know what did you think of the final. The sooner the better. I really like to enjoy it. I think France failed to capitalize when Ronaldo went down. I mean, never forget fire forward he's done. But, yeah, we bounced back. That's what matters. Ericsson tries to play it back, can't do so. It's half time.
Signal for half time, and it's 1-0 here. Well, the player that we're featuring here has done well. He's certainly been an influence on this first half.
Yeah, and what a good time to score that one.
There we go. 1-0. The front three are fucking knackers. I mean, I'm gonna have to bring Schwello on already. Yeah, Lupi on. Ericsson has to come off. Same with Salado Santos. So, yeah, I'm sorry for Hamill, but you're just gonna have to stay. Maybe we could put Karakanak off center and leave you there. No. It has to be Schwello. Sorry, lads. Just please hold on. Don't get any injuries. That's my goal. We're already 1-0 in front, so we don't need to push that high for a goal anymore. Even though a second would be nice. But we don't need to rush forward. Nathan Cavada now. That's the main thing. We can play calmly like the CPU does.
That is a free kick.
How the fuck is that a foul? That's a clean tackle, man. Wake the fuck up. Rossignol punches it well. And Schwello on the edge of the area can't get it. Then Levy does well to turn his man. Gives it on the wings to Porter. Lays it off. Hamill. Now Schwello. Oh my god, he's injured him for that. Fuck off. Right, Clisby's gonna send this one in. It's a header, it's hit the post. Porter. And the rebound. It's in. Yes. I'd like the header to go in, but I'll take it. Great header, hits the post. Then keeper saves the rebound, and then finally, at the third attempt, Porter gets it in. The left back. There you go. Three goals in the championship for him. Very good offensive wing back. That's what I like. That's why I always put the guys on there, because they can always make an impact with their pace and ball control, etc. And look,
Castro.
To Castro. Grimes, again Castro. Headed out by Epstein. Hamill completes the clearance. Schwello gets it in front for Dunleavy. He's got the pace. Good fake shot, but can't get the shot off. Well played by the Blackburn Rovers defender. There he is, Henley again taking the ball off Clisby. Grimes. Back to Arthur Worthy. Worry. Castro.
Tommy Spur.
There's Spur. Hughes. Castro. Back to Mesa Quevedo. There's Grimes. Mesa Quevedo again. Clisby, what a superb job he's done today. Brad Clisby, take him out again. There he is. It's just a throw after the tackle. That's why I like him. He's a good ball recovery and he can go on and build himself because he has the pace and the strength, the stamina, yeah, everything on the physical. And the ball control and dribbling required to do so. There you go. Porter sends it through. Schvolo doesn't have the pace. Fuck. Oh yes, Schvolo gets it back though. He's got the technical skill. Can't get past the first man. Fuck me.
Tommy Spur.
Henley boots it forward.
Out of the danger zone.
And good header out.
The home side want to make.
Castro. Simpson now. Well done by Epstein. That's what I meant on signing him. He can tackle the guys. Then Levy. Back to Luke. He's going to whip it in at the far post. Schvolo can't get the on the end of that. Well cleared by the Blackland defender. Oh, well done, Schvolo. Keep the pressure on.
Castro.
Quisby does well, lays it off. Schvolo, Levy, Hamill, good vision to find Lupi, and Lupi finesses it. Bad decision by me. Thought he would take it with his left, but he took it with his right. And we can't make anything off the corner.
Tommy Spur. Castro.
Back to Castro. Gets it inside, and the shot is absolutely appalling. He's made a hash of that. Booted forwards. There is Anderson. Well, I didn't mean to take it there, but there you go. That's FIFA for you.
That's going to run on through to Ross, the goalkeeper.
Gathers it very nicely.
Well, you can see what he was trying to do, but the pass wasn't on.
Can't get a fucking pass on. Good tackle from Coquete Russo. Epstein, very well done to lay it off to Charles. Coquete Russo, over now to Clisby. Gets this one through, then Levy. Gets it through to Schvolo, but he's just knackered now. There he goes. Solid performance by the team. Taking those last 10 minutes being a perfect game.
The tackle there is successfully done.
And the first 15 minutes as well.
Castro.
The rest of the team has just been rock solid. There's Graham. Still Graham.
They cope with it well defensively.
And they've not even let us get on the counter attack. There you go. Still, 2-0 win. Solid win. I think Ross deserved this clean sheet. Only two shots on target, though, from them. Clisby, man of the match by a mile. No one else deserved it more, to be honest. Maybe Porter, but I think Clisby was just on another level. Any other day he'd been the man of the match. 5 shots, 4 on target, that's decent. Where is West Brom? They've won 2-1 against Southend United. Fuck.
English Football League Championship.
Yeah, still in
Birmingham
second.
City, nil.
Next
Ipswich
match
Town,
is a
one.
Big one.
Blackburn
and
Rovers, nil.
Yeah.
Carlisle United, 2.
But then
Bristol
your contract.
Nil.
Relvers Oliveira
wants
a huge
Burnley, 2. Cardiff City,
increase
3.
On his wage.
Derby County, 1.
Have we
Nottingham
them?
Forest, 2. Fulham, 2. Charlton
Fuck
Athletic,
me, I just
nil.
Forgot who it was.
Leeds United, 2. Bournemouth,
there,
nil.
Relvers Oliveira,
Reading,
remember
1.
That.
Huddersfield Town,
Relvers
nil.
Oliveira sent
Sheffield
back,
United,
so
nil. Brighton
go,
Hove Albion,
like
1.
There. Oh, currently negotiating,
2.
Nice.
Middlesbrough, 1.
So I've already
Southend
sent him
United,
that.
1. West Bromwich Albion, 2.
Next match against Spurs. I mean, I think we've done well in the cup, but Now that the first teamers are just knackered, maybe not all. I mean, got Clearsby, Salero, Santos, Eriksen, and Krakenakov. Charles is good to play. Ross is always good to play, to be honest. Yeah, Moscardo Silva is back, which isn't decent. He can replace Hamill in the center midfield spot. We could put Clearsby down at the holding mid, and then Charles there, and then Moscardo Silva fits in perfectly. But Hayashida is good to play. I think Epstein just a bit too tired to play. Yeah, Hayashida plays on that side. Dunleavy is a bit tired, so Walker comes on. Maybe Cairo to come on for Porter. Yeah, let's rest the first team as Anderson. Anderson can play. Yeah, he can play. Charles, Solero Santos, everything is cool. Loopy, Brothers Novice is back. Amin can stay on the bench now. Yalsin is back, decent. Can get on Loopy's place, because he played in the last match and needs a bit down in stamina. He can recover. Maybe he can come in, yeah. Take off. Fuck, it's a tough one. Take off who? Take off Raldazola. Yeah, let's do it like this. Teshka, if we need, he can do in the defense if we have anything there. He can do center back with that height. He can do both wing backs because he's left footed and it says there he's listed at right back. So it's just perfect. So anything that happens. Center defensive mid, yeah. We've got Hamill, we've got Tambay, sorry. And we've got Walker for center mid, center attacking mid, etc. And we've got three good guys for up front, yeah. It's gonna be a tough decision then, but I'll leave it for later. There you go. But you just gotta see how it goes. Crossing skill challenge. I'm terrible at crossing. Well, I'm not terrible at crossing, but I'm not good enough. I need to improve there. I mean, look at that. Good cross. Great finish.
Well, we've got 16 clubs now left in the FA Cup at this fifth round stage.
Yeah, and always a bit of magic associated with this competition as it progresses. Wembley gets a little bit closer.
Carlisle United in action today against Tottenham.
Well, I think Spurs. Yeah, if we need to go the attacking threat, we can always go defensive. We're going to go ultra defensive straight away. Because it's Tottenham.
Well, here is the team sheet.
It's fucking Tottenham. And something like Lamella, Eriksen can always pop out of the bag, just like that.
That's the Chadley plays with Eric Lamella looking to provide width. Harry Kane is the main striker today. Kyle Walker.
Ooh, so close to getting the ball.
Here's Walker.
Dele Alli. There is Lamella.
This attack put a bit of menace to it.
Good tackle by Hayashida. Keep it out.
Throw. Quite clear whose throw it is.
Out of the area.
And a sharp restart.
Walker. Good tackle and by Moscato Silva. Lays it off. Salero Santos. Oh, Toby, great tackle from Walker. There is Alderweireld,
Eric Lamella.
Lamella, Dembele,
Kane,
Ali, Kane, Ali, now Dyer. Back to Chadley on the left hand side. How the fuck didn't he tackle him? Now. Yeah, great save, Ross, anyway. Offside.
To get right on
how the fuck
basis,
didn't
offside,
the right back collect that? Right here. That was an easy tackle,
the
right there.
The players rushing through. It's such a
Charles,
difficult decision,
very well done. Hayashida can't turn on the ball quick enough.
Well. Eric Lamella.
Dembele. Dyer. Dyer again. Kane. Well. Tackled beautifully. And again, what a block from Lee. He's definitely going to be the main man in defence right now.
Kane. The shot's up.
Good shot from Harry Kane, just wide. Very promising future ahead of that young kid. Pedro Queiroz decided to give him a run out. See how he goes. Charles. Over to Hayashida. Does well on the left hand side. Salero Santos takes the shot. It's an atrocious one. Should have just smashed it into the near post. Like cross finish. Cross goal finish.
Eriksen.
Like there. Yeah. Like the Ede goal.
Kane. Now they've got a chance in this part of the pitch. That's a serious situation. And on he goes.
Oh, good header from Dembele. He was caught napping there. Big let off. Hope the team wake up after that. There's Lee, shocking through ball. Krakenekov will collect.
Real good.
And another bad through ball. Come on. Kane. Ali. Back to Chadley.
Well, here comes the support.
Very well done. Gets it back. Good tackle from Cairo. Krakenekov. Over. Moscato Silva blocked off the pass. Come on, can't even get out of fucking midfield.
That will be a free kick.
That's a foul. That's a useful foul anyway. So I'll take it. Please don't score, Lamella. Yeah, thank you.
He
can take them all day long like that. I much appreciate it.
A selfish act. Really, I think he's lost his head completely with that decision.
Oh, that's a booking at least. What? Fuck off! Fuck off, ref! How the fuck is that not a foul? Oh my god! Now I got. They didn't check it properly. I mean, look at the shit! Oh my god! The referee's been bribed. He needs to fucking buy some glasses. I mean, look at this. I mean, fair enough, he goes for the ball, but he misses it. Look. He misses it. And he completely takes him out. From the back. Come on. Every day of the week, that's a booking. Ball, that's a bad ball, come on! Lamella, charging through the right hand side.
Kane.
It's our left. It's their right now.
Here's the shot.
There's a good save from Ross and well cleared by Anderson. It's a good through ball. Krakenekov can't hold up play. Still falls to Eriksen. Back to Krakenekov now. Good turn inside. Good skip off on the feet. And that's a goal for Krakenekov. Excellent feet footwork from Krakenekov to get around the defender. And he's through on goal. Here he avoids the challenge. Goes on. Great dribble. Why to do pointless kill moves? And you can just dribble like that. Great finish from Krakenekov. We are 1-0 and we're playing fucking defensive all match. How about that? Taking one off the CPU's book, that's for sure.
Eric Lamella. How frustrating is this
being
counter-attacking.
Kane. Chadley, that's offside. Good clearance off by Hayashida.
Here we are.
That's
with
a
Tottenham,
bad ball.
Perhaps flattering to deceive. Build up to this game is big for them. The performance hasn't been big.
Chip forward. Cairo deals with it nicely.
There is plenty of time.
I don't mind that's a corner. That's still a good clearance.
Tottenham
prevented him to
now.
Take the volley, didn't it? So there you go.
It's a goalkeeper who's
good.
Himself
calmly
the
collected. Ross Agnon gathers it and
off
throws it badly, but it's a foul. There's Glisby, the man in form so far, this episode. Doing well, skipping past a couple of challenges. Now's a good tackle, apparently. Whatever, ref. Well done. Get back into your position, mate. And that's half time. Nice. So I didn't expect to go 1-0 up. But since we are, I'm going to keep this team like it is. I'm just going to do the three changes up front. Maybe two and leave the third for the final minutes of the game. So, Morales and Navarro go there. And I think that... Wait. Walker and Yalton. Let's compare some. I think, yeah. Stamina, way better on Walker, but pace is definitely on the Yalton's side. Pace and agility in balance. Technicals, Yalton's, but finishing is definitely on Walker. That's the main skill attribute. Shot power on Walker's side as well. Short pass, Walker. Penalty, Yalton. Penalties don't really matter. Long shots in Yalton, that's a big one. Heading accuracy, I don't give a fuck about heading. Dribbling, way better on Yalton, and curve as well, crossing, ball control as well. Walker's 5'9", Yalton's 6'. Walker's 20 years old, Yalton's just 19. But Walker has a better weak foot, and better work rates as well. Yeah. And he's much thinner. I mean, for a man of his height, than Yalton. No special. I think I have to go with Yalton though. For now, third sub is left.
Double switch now. These sides really,
yeah, because Parakanapo is being definitely the man of the match today.
Second half of this
so
time,
far.
The fifth round tie starts now.
Closely fought in that first half. Should be too much different actually.
Over to Rose. Dembele.
He's moved in, trying to jostle the opponent off his stride.
The Tongan.
Dembele.
Dembele. So, don't think that was a fair challenge. We're gonna shut up because referee didn't pull off that booking earlier.
Kyle Walker. Jan Vertonghen.
There is Chadli.
Dembele. Danny Rose.
Oh, that's a shit ball. Harry Kane's kissed past the man.
Good
tries
to
lay it off
there
and get it back.
The pressure was starting.
Can't
to mount.
Get it done, so.
Was timely,
well done
to
Clisby to hold around the ball. Very well done. Lays it off. Charles is free in the middle of the park.
Eric
can't
Bell.
Get the ball through. Very well done by Tottenham's defender. Guy just falling around. Very well done. Good ball. There we go. Mraz Navaez lays it off. It's Yalton. Over to Karakunakov. Lays it off. It's Mraz Navaez. Oh, fuck. Can't control it. Shame. Good header in. Yalton lays it off.
Yalton.
Well done, Mraz Navaez turns his man. Good save from Hugo Lloris.
They've gone up to take the throw well up the field and keep the pressure on.
Charles. Oh, that's a foul. That's what I thought. Right. Is Loopy a good free kick taker? Answer is yes, he is. I'm going to get him on and maybe take on the free kick with him if he's the best taker.
I
think the best is Yalton still. Yeah. Yalton, you go up. Yalton takes the free kick and it's a very close one.
Martin,
I think the keeper just
there.
Had it covered.
It was a high class effort,
good strike.
A little bit off target.
Definitely a good strike.
There because it was extremely
I was afraid
close.
To put more power on it because you know how easy the ball can just fly into the barricade and the crowd of people. There it is. Lay it off to Rose. Now Chadley. Where about the window?
Yeah, for Tonga.
Lots of wind here in Lisbon. Moscato Silva. Good through ball. Lupi. Well done. It's a goal. It's a goal for Lupi. The third change has worked.
That into the top left hand corner. One of the best goals he scored this
what
year.
What
a sure.
Finish! I was right about the third sub. He makes a lot more impact coming just 15 minutes
well
later.
Taken.
And he gets a goal. That's what matters. And we are definitely going to win Tottenham by this. That's a very good test on our Premier League credential, because Tottenham are a great side and we aren't playing with our fully starting 11, even. I mean, Cato and Hayashida's wing backs. Not even close.
Kyle Walker. And they're keeping the ball now, passing it nicely. Almost lost his balance.
Cato's done very well, to be honest.
Well, offside.
Still good block from Lee. Rock solid at the back with Anderson.
Be happy if those forwards continue to be quite as boneless as that.
There they are.
Substitution
Hayashida.
Coming up.
I mean, the whole team has done well. It's been rock solid.
Charles.
Very well done. Good fake shot inside. Good crossing.
Good take by the goalkeeper, but no pressure on him.
It's close. Lloris punches it out, kicks it out. There is good block. Clisby lays it off. Scardo Silva can't control it. Now he can. Good ball through from Lupi.
And the cross comes.
There's
in
a
now.
Cross. Still too powerful. Braznovic can't control it. Headed out. Lupi collects. Can't give it to his teammates. Moscato Silva and Kane for Tongan is through and our phones go down again. So.
And the offside stops the play. Flag went up. Referee blew.
It's offside in the end, thankfully.
Can Spurs dig themselves out of this? Very sticky situation in the closing minutes here.
There we go. Braznovic, he can use his pace here. Let's give it to his right. And that's a finish.
It's a goal.
3-0. I mean, Tottenham haven't even competed with us.
Well, that's evaded the keeper's
and when
grasp.
You look at their starting 11, they have the Tongan there, Alderweireld, both wing backs, Rose and Wilker.
That
Lloris in the net. They had Lamella, they had Harry Kane, they had Ali.
And
they've got their first team out. We've been there. Taking Mason off for Eriksen, but I know he's a big difference on this Tottenham side. But it's still only one player left. I know it's a big one, but it's just one player. You know, and the team has done well because we've got a couple of guys in, both wing backs, of course. Big difference. As well, not as big as Tottenham's one, but still a difference. Good fake shot, and it's a goal. 4-0. This is fantastic. How can we pick this form in the league? What a game! I mean, hats off to our team.
Exactly what he wanted to do.
I'm actually just gonna applaud it. 4 goals in the Emirates FA Cup. Don't know why they call that. Should just call FA Cup. 4 goals anyway for Luka Lupi. Very happy for him.
Scored twice
today. Definitely going to get my man of the match. I thought maybe Clisby maybe Karakanako. But nah, it's got to be Loopy, isn't it? Well, welcome to whoever joined the stream. We are in the second match of the episode. And guess what for this result? We've been clinical on goal. Told you I'm good at shooting. And four shots on target, four goals. How about that? We had six shots. So there you go. Loopy 8.4. At half time I was giving it to Karakanakov, but nah, it's definitely Loopy's. He's definitely turned things around. Thought Clisby was doing better than that. Lee 7.6 is rock solid. Kaido rock solid. Hayashida rock solid. Ross Sagnon solid in the net as well. And yeah, we are through. We are in the quarterfinals. I told the board that I reached the final, and I'm starting to think that we can do it.
The Football Association Challenge Cup. Arsenal 1, Fulham 1, Carlisle United 4, yeah. Tottenham.
Just
going to
do
nil.
A Charles
Walsall,
full
nil.
Session
Liverpool,
till
2.
West the
Ham
end,
United,
because
three.
I don't have
Bournemouth,
anyone
two.
To train,
Wigan
really.
Wanderers, one.
Anyone else that
Chelsea,
I want to train.
Two.
Charles's physicals are already developed, and he needs to get better on the technical side, so that's what the training is for. Ramos Oliveira's contract standoff. Fuck mate. Stojan Klaassen has accepted this contract. Very nice to hear that. Let's take a look at him. So many loan outs. Sorry. Lobessa, Saunders, where the fuck? That is Alisson, there he is. Stojan Klaassen. Is he Swedish? He is. One star, two star, that's shocking. Good physicals, bad technicals, okay mentals. So 6'2", that's decent. 17 year old, he needs a Maybomb. That's basically it. He's right footed and he's the left back. Oh my god. And he's one star weak foot. No point even on playing him on the left. Just play him on the right. Low, medium, we don't need more wing back, so I'm gonna sell him. Still, decent player to watch. I mean, potential 70 to 94. And Herman Backman. Nah, just keeping him because we don't have anyone else here than Xavi Rodriguez. And he might be useful if someone gets injured, but he's never gonna play. He's 45 overall and he's a playmaker. And his potential's not that high, it's only 68 to 94. By this time we need like 80 to 94. Otherwise it's just shit. That's still 9 points away. Of course we didn't play any match for the league since the last match, which was the first match of the episode. So next game against Fulham. Fulham are in 7th. They are fighting for promotion. Let's get a win against them. There we go. We've got a fully strength side. Got Dunleavy, Loopy and Baradas Novice on the bench as well. Moscato Silva, you're gonna have to come on. And you go off and Clisby? No. We'll leave Moscato Silva off for now. Because he's not that good up front. Yalcin, think. No, he's better than... Nah, Dunleavy's better. Dunleavy's better than him. I mean, the ball control doesn't need that much. Same with the dribbling. And the curve, the crossing as well. Free kick accuracy doesn't matter much. Long shots, big one to Yolfin. Penalties as well. Short pass and short power better on Dunleavy. Better volleys on Yolfin. Better weak foot on Dunleavy. But I think, because we want to bet on the Youth Academy players, I'm going to have to put Yolfin ahead of him. And I really want to boost the Portuguese hopes for a new World Cup with a fully regen team. So that's why I'm waiting for the Portuguese job. I've got to boost guys like Barradas Novais. Got to boost guys like Relvas Oliveira. Etc, you know. Like Salero Santos as well. That's why I bought him. And his contract was expiring in 12 months. There you go. Fully strength side. We've got pretty good bench as well. I mean, this team is Premier League quality. Let's be honest. This team is so ready for the Premier League. The goal for this season was to gain automatic promotion, and we are completing it at the moment. Let me just finish the drill. There we go.
Hi there again, everybody. I'm Martin Tyler, and Alan Smith's with
it's
me for
raining
this
here
championship
at Paul Hart.
Yeah, I'm Martin. Really pleased to be here.
Let's hope that doesn't affect our play as much.
In action today.
And yeah, Vardy and Ebolo and Mbolo on Fulham's lineup. How about realistic?
Easy to use that
realistic
speed,
career mode, please. Come on. Bolo and Vardy to Fulham. Vardy's just won the Premier League, and Bolo's just gone to Swiss. To Switzerland national side. He could feature in any team in Europe, and he goes to fucking Fulham in the Championship even. In the same. Come on. That's not realistic. Mbolo. Oh, come on. Come on, hold up. Yes. Still gonna be. They are still 7th, even with Mbolo and Vardy. Maybe Vardy's getting on a bit. That's why he's gone to Fulham, maybe that's why. But Mbolo, come on, he's 23. I think he was 82, 83 rated. Something Fulham like that.
In possession again.
Just ridiculous.
Nice bit of interplay between these two.
Hamill gets it onside. It's a good strike, but it's a good save as well. I think that's Stecklenburg in the net. Look, Garbutt, he has moved from Everton to Fulham. I think they've reached the Premier League somehow while we were on the lower division. So they could get all these signings in. He's offside. Knew that. Welcome to Ever During the Stream, third match of the episode. We smashed Tottenham 4-0, that's the highlight so far.
It was a draw when these two teams met earlier in the season, so I don't think there's much between them now, is there?
Not an awful lot, no. And if I was a betting man, I think I would put my money on a draw again here.
There's Hamill. Good feet, got work from Hamill, and he scores. He runs after the camera and celebrate. Can't get my words out. Fuck's sake.
Stroking it home into the top right.
Great finish. Good footwork. And then the finish as well. From the holding mid.
Again by the replay of the goal.
Have some ammo.
That has opened
Take
the scoring. 1-0 here. Little piece of interplay between the two.
There is Kaka Niklic. Rate him highly as a player, maybe too highly.
Christensen.
Tom
Kearney.
Christensen wasn't that centre back in Borussia Mönchengladbach. He was solid. No. From Chelsea. It's the other Christensen. I bet it's from Chelsea. Salero Santos. Skips around his marker. and he gets it back. There's Kenny. Good tackle from Harrison Arnold. Keep to run the half play. Can't quite keep the ball
in the field.
You can see
what he was trying to do. Just stretch the opposition
Fulham.
By getting the ball out wide, but it's gone out for a throw.
Porter. Over to Epstein. Gets around his man. That's
it's
foul.
A free
thank
kick.
You.
But the referee has decided
holding
to
his knee. Someone fucking take the ball. Thank you.
Well, going into this game for the
take
home
it,
side.
Football.
They're in great
fucking now. Oh my god, there's three balls in this game. Just kill me.
Full of confidence, the way that they've been playing, created chances, taking them. Very good.
Hutchinson.
Go back to the goalkeeper. Stecklenburg.
Grimmer.
Tom Kearney.
Ince. Vardy. Kearney. I mean, to be honest, the defense doesn't look that great. Taking Stecklenburg. But the attack.
Frustrating is
yeah,
this
taking Galbert in the defense.
The
anyone else?
Goal kick here.
I don't know anyone else, so I bet the defense is the fault why they're seventh and not like third. Maybe even first. There's Galbert. Oh my god, Christensen is through, and that's a goal. We won 4-0 to Tottenham, and now we are struggling against Fulham. Even though they've got Vardy and Mbolo, we are struggling against them. And to be honest, Vardy and Mbolo haven't been that great. I barely see them. Then taking kickoff.
They were in a good position until that defender acted very promptly and decisively. Ince.
There you go, Hutchinson. Garbutt. Ince. That's not Tom Ince. Porter.
Well, there's some
still
drama
Porter.
In the game being watched by our good
Can
friend Alan McAnally.
Lay it
off.
Off,
I believe.
There's
Alan.
Hamill. It's a red card for back to Charles. Hamill can't take the shot off for fuck's sake. It remains
1-0. Well, many thanks, Alan
Epstein.
McAnally.
Give it on the other
date,
side. Porter miscontrols it for fuck's sake. When can they control the fucking ball? There's the keeper. Grimmer, miscontrol, still got it though. Garbutt smashes it towards Kakaniklic. Perfect touch. Vardy. Karakunakov. Hamill. Oh my god, fuck off, ref! Eriksson, yeah, you haven't been that great today. Yalsin comes on, Barradas Novais comes on, and the main man last match, Loopy. Can he make a difference? I hope so, and Barradas Novais and Yalsin as well. Hope them three can do a difference, because we haven't. The strikers have played poorly. I mean, Hamill's been a better finisher than them three together today.
Good forward play from them.
And they are good strikers, so.
Here's Porter.
Porter gets it inside, Barradas Novais, what a save! What a save, and that's a foul. I agree. There's Langberg, Stearman, Garbutt. Over to Kakaniklic, gets it through to Christensen. Doing a couple of heavy touches. Oh, enough to get past our man. Clisby can't turn out
the
ball. Well
eye,
done from Mbolo. Playing better defense than the actual defense for Fulham.
Lost his man. He's cut out that pass. It wasn't an accident. He read the mind of the opponent. Yalsin.
Good through ball. Finds Loopy. He's alone. And that's a bad effort. Come on, Loopy. Wake up. That should have been yours. Yalsin connects with the ball. What a hit. It's Yalsin's day and my choice. is confirmed now. My choice on him is justified, that's what I mean. There he is. He's telling me.
Into the corner.
That's why I deserve to be on the pitch today. What a hitter. Through the crowd of bodies and into the back of the net.
Fulham need to
not even the keeper
fortify themselves
to save it.
At the moment they are behind.
We're finally comfortable in the driving seat. So, yeah.
Pack
Miklic.
And the crowd really enjoying it. Trying to keep the ball.
Charles. Good through ball. And oh my god, that's a foul. That's a booking. That's a booking. The ball was going through. Straight.
Referee
yeah.
Has shown the player
that,
thought
so. Thought so. Took so much time, though he wasn't going to give it. Porter.
Good
tackle from
in.
Kearney.
System working out which way it is.
Porter with the throw. Quisby. Gets it on for Hamill. Turns his man beautifully. And then the pass is blocked.
Christensen.
Oh, good one too.
We've got the away manager indicating he wants
Hinman
to make a substitution.
Ray
now.
Nate.
Tom Kearney.
Back to the great
the
man.
Position back off. They could
the
be
great
in trouble.
Name.
And the ball
himself.
Gets
there is Kearney. Good block from Anderson.
Good defensive
stop
play.
The
no
cross from coming in. Quisby
no
keeps
now.
Around his marker.
Any thoughts on Fulham's next fixture, Alan?
Begin the counter attack.
Arsenal in the next match
Loopy.
In the FA Cup. And,
there he goes.
And,
inside. Loopy! Come
keep
on.
His there
it's just
on
not been his day. The second time he's lost. The shot.
Him. It's a tactical substitution for the losing team here.
It's definitely been the Austin today, though. Loopy. Very well done.
Charles.
Back to Charles.
And here comes the
back
counter-tack.
To Loopy. Can he finish it? Third time lucky. There we go. Loopy with the third. And that's his fifth goal. Oh no, sorry, that was the FA Cup,
the
my bad.
Here.
There's his first goal this match, third for Carlisle.
So
good through ball there, but
the
he
game.
Just couldn't finish. He couldn't miss them
let's
there,
the
to be honest. And free from marking as well. Great finish with his left.
It is now, the scoreline. Alan McAnally wants Tunic to join
Crest.
Us now, he's got
Washington.
A goal to tell us about.
It's the second goal for Wolverhampton Wanderers. 74 minutes played. 2-1.
Haven't
thank
seen
much,
anything
Alan.
Of Mbolo really. Vardy, good finish. Vardy popping,
finish.
Popping up just like
goal.
That.
And the keeper's got no chance because he's hitting so hard.
We are
to
back
right.
To one goal cushion.
Goals here today. 3-2.
Vardy's just like a possessed man. Look at him, chasing Porter now. He's calmed down finally. Through to Hamill, can't get it past the second man.
Hutchinson. Well, this is the breakaway.
Vardy goes through, skips past
right,
Mike Anderson.
Coming up at speed.
Over to the far
that's
post.
A he's found his teammate. Here's a chance to whip it in. That's a useful ball in.
That's a bad ball in. Yalsin. Over to Baraz Navaez. Gets it on the wing. This is for Loopy's pace. He gets past the wing back just like he's not even
oh,
there.
The
it's a low cross and it's a finish. Don't know who that is because apparently it was the CPU who scored
it.
Still very good pace from Loopy.
Well,
then it's a bit deflected.
A lot of composure,
but
not
I think
skill to
that is Baraz's voice.
Like another angle on it here.
Can't see who it is.
4-2 is the score.
No, it's Clisby. Clisby, where'd you come from? All the way back to Senemir's. Red strikes him, even though it was deflected. Good block from Porter.
It gone out for a throw.
And that's a throw in for us. Nice. That's a foul. Pushed him with both hands. Clisby The three goes out of play here quite clearly. They just piss you off.
Not a good one. Tom Kearney. 3 minutes left of the 90-minute match. Dembele.
Vardy. Now there Hutchinson.
Good work,
and Ross collects. Nice. Gets it forward. It's Barabas Novice trying to create something. Can't hold a play at least. Oh, very close on getting that ball back. Vardy.
That's going to run on through to the goalkeeper.
Tries to get the ball through, but no one finds it. That was for Barabas Novice, who decided to run into the corner flag. Good tackle from Porter. Gets it out, and that's the full-time whistle. There we go. Carlisle United 3, Fulham 1. Great game. There's a substitute running onto the pitch to congratulate their teammates on their win. Yeah, 7 shots, 6 on target to Fulham's only 3. So, same shot accuracy in terms of goals. 2 shots on target, but that 100% because they hit the target all the time. Loopy man of the match, I don't agree. I think Yalson was, and I think that Loopy was second best today behind Yalson. I think they should have switched the ratings that they've got. Maybe the same, but not Loopy to get the man of the match. Clisby did well.
English Football League Championship.
Hamill did well.
Bournemouth 2. Derby
Charles
County,
did well as
one.
Well.
Brentford 1. Reading 2.
There is on
Cardiff
the training
City,
pitch.
1. Sheffield Wednesday
and
0. Carlisle United 4.
West Brom didn't play.
2.
I'm just checking
Town,
it on the
1. Leeds United
stream.
1.
Bad training
2.
Session for Charles.
Blackburn Rovers
West
2.
Brom didn't even play.
Nottingham Forest 1.
Hoping them
Burnley,
to lose points.
Nil.
They didn't
Wigan
lose
Athletic,
points. Fuck's sake.
Southend United
they always
2.
Lost points in the other save. Now they
2.
Just can't find a
Sheffield
way
United,
to lose one.
1. Now let's see what effect that's had on the league standings. At the top of the table remain West Bromwich Albion with 76 points, with a game in hand on the team below.
Offer resting
in second, Carlisle United
from
with
South
70
Africa.
Points.
Don't
in
care.
Third,
Ball.
Burnley with 55 points. In fourth, Wolverhampton
not
Bournemouth
really sure,
with
yeah.
55 points, but only behind on goal difference. In fifth, rising up the table are
Xavi Rodriguez
going to
promote him right
in
now.
Sixth,
might
in
be able to sell
Brighton
him off later.
With
same with
points,
you,
with
really.
A game in hand on the team above. In 7th, Fulham with 48 points. In 8th, climbing the table
Herman
are
Batman.
Middlesbrough with 48 points, but only behind on goal difference. Bottom of the table, moving down, are Sheffield
next
United
training
with
session,
22
let's
points.
Hope Charles steps
and then
up
reading
the play.
Up the table, second bottom, rising up the
bang,
table
and he does so.
United
3 season 1B,
points.
That's decent
third
enough
bottom,
for me.
Huddersfield Town with
I'll
26 points, but only behind on goal difference. Fourth bottom, Bristol City with
prize money for what? So both players have accepted it. 180k from the FA Cup. Let's take a look at the two new guys. Adam Charles Hamill. Yeah. Xavi Rodriguez, there he is. Checking the names tab. 61 of 16, not gonna grow in physicals, unfortunately. Great player, he's got what? Potential to be special, that's great. 92 to 94 potential, so that's sick. He's from Spain, 2-star, 5-star, that's decent enough for me. I know one player that was quality and had them. Weak for one to kill moves, and that's Callum McGugan from Cutsy's side in this year's FIFA. Where's the other guy? Joelo Gouveia, Bradley Reed, there's Backman. He is shocking. He's not right back in the first place. He's more of a centre mid for me. I mean, look at his short pass, his vision, his agility and balance. He's got the curve, got the long pass, the long shots even, and his tackling is shocking. His ball control and dribbling is shocking. His aggression and interceptions is shocking all over the place. Stamina, okay. Crossing, okay. Not great, which you would have hoped for a right back. Might wind up even terminating his contract in the first team if we need him to. And I think that's a new month, so I'm going to do a quick squad report. There you go. Oscar Rossagnon, overall of 77, gone up by 1. Anton Leander Epstein, overall of 75. David Lee, overall of 78, gone up by 3. Mike Anderson, overall of 76, gone up by 2. Paul Porter, overall of 78, gone up by 2. Love that, excellent form. Adam Charles, overall of 78, gone up by 1. Harrison Amel, overall of 74, gone up by 2. Brad Clisby, overall of 75, gone up by 3. Alexander Karakanakov, overall of 74, gone up by 1. Antonio Leonel Salero Santos, overall of 75, gone up by 3. We've gone up. Gentrit Eriksson, overall of 73, gone up by 2. Jorge Alexandre Barradas Navais, overall of 71, gone up by 3. Luca Lupi, overall 73, gone up by 3. Aaronson Levy, he's gone up. Nice. Overall of 73, gone up by 1. Yannick Teschke, overall of 73, gone up by 2. Sambu Tambe, overall of 73, gone up by 3. Ricardo Andrade, Relvas de Oliveira, overall of 75, gone up by 5. Josh Jessup, great name, overall of 69, gone up by 3. Yeah, nice. Reaction to 69, overall 69. And handling, he's got 69 as well. How many stats have you got at 69 or nah? Anything else is different. Stoyan Klaassen, he's gone up, nice. Overall of 54, gone up by 1. Zlatan Allinson, overall of 58, gone up by 1. He's going to be a great right back in the future. Alexandre Morelos, overall of 67, gone up by 3. Tom Parrish, overall of 55, gone up by 1. I'm just going to have to sell him off because he hasn't got a face. He's come from the Youth Academy this year. Alexander Oliver, overall 76, gone up by 2. Amazing how he's holding up. Even though he's gone down in this month in acceleration, in speed and agility. Still holding up into that 76 overall. Lars Tibbling, overall of 60, gone up by 2. Can finally see his status. And that is exciting prospect. Nice, that's nice to see. Jason Kroll, overall of 64, gone up by 2. We all know he's an exciting prospect. Yasuo Hayashida, overall of 73, gone up by 3. Xabi Rodriguez, the new kid, has potential to be special. 61, right mid. Jakob Kalkvist, overall of 51, gone up by 1. Pedro Queiro, he has gone up. Nice, great physicals. 72 overall, gone up by 3. Charles Ameng, overall of 72, gone up by 2. Jack Saunders, he's gone up, finally. Overall of 65. Not finally, because we signed him. Bruh. That was shocking. Anyway, let's move on. Lucas Sasaka, overall 73, gone up by 3. Morides Coquete Russo, overall of 75, gone up by 6. Tamsanka Lavesa, great name, overall of 68, gone up by 1. This is Steven Pienaar's region. Severino Pedro Moscato Selva, overall of 74, gone up by 2. Jeremy Yalcin, overall of 73, gone up by 2. Emmet Svolo, overall of 72, gone up by 2. David Gouveia, overall of 62, gone up by 2. Liang Mao, overall of 70, gone up by 2. Matthew Walker, overall of 71, gone up by 4. Bradley Reed, overall of 54, gone up by none. Herman Backman, great name, overall of 45, just came on from the Youth Academy. He's a playmaker, we're going to move him on in the next transfer window. Yi Wang, overall of 68, gone up by 2. Ebenezer, now the low and easy, yeah. Ebenezer Addo, 68 overall, gonna buy 2 on loan at Bolton Wanderers. Duarte Nunes, overall 72, gonna buy 1 on loan at Barcelona. Alex Watson, overall a 68, gonna buy 2. Can't see stats. He is on loan at MK Dons, former Wimbledon FC. Badil Lezugo, overall 70, gone up by 2, on loan at Sheffield Wednesday. Marcus Albrechtsen, difficult name that to pronounce, 68 overall, gone up by 4, on loan at FC Bayern Munich. I wonder how many games he's played for them. If he's played even one, I'll be happy for him. So, how long has this episode been? Yeah. 1 hour, that's fine by me. Hayden, you have a great channel, deserve a sub. Yeah, I'll check you after the episode, don't worry. So here's the final league table. We're still 9 points away from fucking West Brom. They just can't seem to lose a game now. They're gonna run with it any day of the week. Top goal scorers, Krakenakov's on 11 and Baradas Navai's on 10. Lupi's on the top goal scorers sheet. That's nice to see. Assists on the FA Cup. Now we'll check the assists for the championship. There is Charles tied in first with 5 more other players. Moscato Selvin second, tied with a shitload of players. Karakanekov in third, tied with a shitload of players. There you go. So thank you guys for watching. Unfortunately I don't have time for more today, but I think I'll catch you guys up tomorrow. So yeah. But don't wanna promise anything. So, see ya.